Hey, Chris here, doing some cube today. You're on Le Channel Fireball. I'm not liking this pack. It's not that impressive. There's some okay cards. There's some cards that aren't that great. I'm a big fan of Ameria Angel just as a card, but I don't think I want to pick it here. There's certainly an All Is Dust deck that's fun. I could see doing that, but I mean, I think the pick for me is just Factor Fiction. I love Factor Fiction, especially in Cube. It's just so much power. Even the lands are often quite good, so it's just, you're gonna get something off it that's amazing. So what do I want to do with it? There's nothing in here that's just really screaming at me. I could take Sun Titan. Sun Titan's a really good finisher, and it works well with Factor Fiction. I'm not really a Future Sight guy, but I don't hate the card. I could also just take Mana Fixing and grab like Savannah or something and just plan to go a lot of colors. I also could take Finkel, which is my kind of card. I like doing that. But I feel like the best card in the pack and the best way to send a signal is to take Sun Titan, so I'm just going to do that. Build kind of a control-ish deck. Not this control-ish, no. I would need a reanimation plan for that. I may just take Flooded Strand here. Kind of either that or maybe like Spellskite or Manowar. But I probably would just want to start getting some land. It's unfortunate that Savannah and Trop have already gone, but we haven't seen Tundra, so that's a good thing. Let's see. Manowar's really powerful. It's actually a pretty underrated card, and it's a good way to survive the early game. Same goes for Spellskite, good way to survive the early game. But I think I want to get Mana Fixing while I can, so I'm just going to do that. And hope that I can find other cards that work well. Okay, so not a lot of great cards. Don't really like dealing with Thunderblast, that card's pretty strong. Could take another potential fixer in Misty Rainforest. I don't know that this is looking like an 8.5 Tails deck yet, but it could. I might just also want Brainstorm. I do have a fetch already, by the way, so Brainstorm might make sense for that reason. I think I'm actually just gonna take the Brainstorm and go from there. I may be going a little too dirtily here. It's possible I should just take the Calcederm or something, or take the, I mean, it would be Calcederm if I was taking something else. But I don't know. It's not my kind of thing. Hey, Snapcaster Mage, that's my kind of thing, and so is Vidalkin Shackles. Gosh, both of those cards are very powerful. For that matter, so is Knight of the White Orchid. I really love this guy. So I have to figure out whether I want Shackles here or Snapcaster. And I do have Sun Titan to bring it back if it dies. Yeah, I'm probably going to have to really highly value Island Duels if I get the Shackles. But I still feel like, even with a couple of good targets for Snapcaster already, I'd rather have the Shackles. We'll see how that works out. Well, I have another really dirtily control card available in Decree of Justice. I could take Days, just as a way to survive for a while, but it's not the kind of survival I want to do. So I think I'm actually going to get a little greedy here and just take Electrolyze. it's possible that none of this would make my deck. I don't think that I can afford to take something as slow as Decree here, and I'm not that big a fan of it anyway. Okay. So I can take Underground Sea and consider that I might want to be those colors at some point. I could take a Chroma's Vengeance, which is reasonable. It is a 6-mana thing that destroys a lot of stuff. And I look somewhat like an Chroma's Vengeance deck so far. Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna just take that. We'll see if it's wrong later. I mean, Underground Sea is pretty strong. Ooh, Cataclysm. I'm definitely not a Cataclysm deck. I probably am a Forbid deck, but I do need to get a little more card draw before that makes sense. Obviously wishing I hadn't passed the Underground Sea right now, because I love Shrieking Grotesque. That's my kind of card. And it would give me a nice early play. But I guess I'm just going to take Forbid. I need to find some mana acceleration, basically. Alright, so Bant Charm made it back. And nothing else I particularly want. I guess I could take Cascade Bluffs, but I mean, I'm playing Shackles, so I don't really want to play non-island blue sources. Boros Garrison would make a lot of sense, too. Kind of like Boros Garrison here. I don't know that I want to... I could take Bant Charm to get the best card, but I think I just want to take Boros Garrison. More slow cards, that's the plan here. This pack has nothing for me at this point. I can take Future Sight, I guess, in case I end up the kind of deck that can play a Future Sight. But, nah, that's about it. Alright, I'm definitely taking Shining Shoal this time. Because I may actually just need it. I don't know, I could take Pact of Negation also, but... nah. Could take Mentor. That doesn't seem to make any sense at all. I'm just gonna take Shoal. Be super dirtly. Alright, well here, I'm finally taking something that's not dirtly. Either that or I'm taking Forspike. I could take Forspike. That's also not dirtly. And I can discard it to Forbid later. Let's do that. Oh, good. I like mana fixing and all, but this card can be really powerful sometimes, especially if you're on the draw. And if I manage to find a Hallowed Fountain or a Tundra, it's going to be the nut, so I'm just going to take it. Ravings is more card draw, and I guess I'm not that worried about Genju. I'm a little bit worried about it, because, I mean, it's very powerful, but if there was a mono-red deck out there that wanted to play that, they probably would have taken it by then. All right. What do I have here? There's Consecrated Sphinx. Another good way to win games. And there's Strip Mine, which is just really strong. But I feel like the pick here for me is probably Elspeth. Yeah, there's nothing else that can really stand up to Elspeth in this pack. I would actually have to think about it if there was a Tundra. But I think I'm just going to take Elspeth. Planeswalkers in Cube are just always awesome. And she's the kind of stall that I need to make it to what my deck is doing late game. Planeswalkers also, of course, work very well with the Chroma's Vengeance because they live. So that's a mild interaction to worry about, but nothing too important. So now we have the option to take, well, there's Vindicate. Makes me wish I had gotten the Underground Sea instead of the Electrolyze. But I think Glenelandra Archmage is fine here. Let's have a look by cost and see where I'm at here. Ooh, I like the Boros Garrison Knight of the White Orchid interaction. Hadn't even really thought of that. I mean, I sort of had, but not terribly much. Yeah, I think I'm going to take Archmage here. It's the kind of card that can help me stall, which I am going to need to do in some games. This deck is just so dirtily. Here I'm going to take Chain Lightning. I still somewhat have a plan to take to splash the red. And I don't want to take another slow card. I could take Mystic Snake, but that just seems really pushing it. Chain Lightning will fit pretty well in my deck, but it's kind of annoying that it's not just Lightning Bolt. Alright, so now I have to pick between Swords to Plowshares and Jace Bellerin. So, really wish these had come in different packs, because both of them will be insane in my deck. They're, of course, very good against different decks. And Jace is just, I mean, Jace Sun Titan is so sweet and so hard to pass up. Palladium Mirror would actually be really good in my deck, too. And I would definitely play it. Gosh, I really hate to pass Jace. But I think I'm going to. Because Swords is just that good in my deck. Yeah, we're going to take Swords. That's the toughest pick that's come so far. I think what I really need is mana fixing. Alright, we're gonna hide this black. Or at least hide this Putrid Imp. It's annoying me. Okay, Glacial Fortress is pretty strong. Tithe is wonderful. Wrath of God is Wrath of God. I think I have to take Wrath of God. I could take Glacial Fortress, I don't know. No, I'm gonna take Wrath of God. Yeah, this is the play. I'm definitely a Wrath deck. We'll just take it. I kind of like where this deck is going. I just really need a Tundra. Alright, so there's actual Lightning Bolt. We also have Sacred Foundry and Condemn. How much do I want to play against creature decks? I think it's Condemn over Lightning Bolt here. But it's probably Sacred Foundry over both of them. I don't like to see Curse Scroll there. That card's going to be annoying for me to face. Now I'm wishing I had taken Jace, because then I could just slam Condemn here and be happy. But I think I'm just going to take Sacred Foundry. And here it's definitely... I don't know if it's Marsh Flats. There's Detention Sphere. That's actually tough. I do have a fetch already. I'm more looking for the lands to work with it. The Marsh Flats would be very nice with my Brainstorm, of course. But Detention Sphere is Detention Sphere. It still gets rid of almost anything problematic and helps me survive the early game. I also could just take Knight of Glory. Sweet card. But I think I'm going to take Detention Sphere. Also, just because of the interaction with, like, Fact or Fiction or Forbid, getting rid of it, and then bringing it back with Sun Titan. And, ding! Luckily still in the pack for 8th pick, which is fairly unreal. Luckier than I deserve to be, by far. But it's an easy pick here. A Johnny is nice. It's a Planeswalker, after all, but it doesn't fit my deck at all. And, yeah, I mean, it's Tundra by a mile. So nothing too interesting came back. I guess I can take Spell Pierce. I don't know that I'll main it. I might. I might play it, but I'm not sure. Dismiss is maybe pushing it on how dirtily I want to be. And there have been some really problematic artifacts that have gone around, so I'm going to take Disenchant here. Probably... I might consider just maining Disenchant. There have been that many that have gone by. So nothing really for me here. Could take Caves of Koilos, but I think that that ship has sailed. It doesn't really matter what I take. I guess I could take Braids, which is an annoying card. Okay, Condescend I will be happy with, but I'm not sure if I take it over Battlefield Forge. It's another good control-ish kind of card. Yeah, and I don't really want to have painful lands in my deck other than the fetch. Chaos Warp is a little too risky for me. And I actually like Tithe, especially now that I have the Tundra and the Sacred Foundry. I mean, if we need early defense, this guy's not bad. Certainly would be worth boarding. This guy is not early defense.